Good morning, children. Today I came with an interesting topic for 6th class children who enters high school. Newly children, newly joined into high school. So, let us see some examples. See, I took a glass of water. I kept this stick inside the water. Now, when you keenly observe, some part of the stick is becoming wet. So, after removing the wet part, you try to hold towards the left side and dry part towards the right side. Clear, children? Once again, I repeat. The wet part which is inside the water, you hold it towards the left side and the dry part towards the right side. Okay, and it is clear now. Take this example. Now, this red color, imagine this is wet part, and white color, this is dry part, and the point of intersection of these two colors is our zero. Now I'll draw the same example on the board. Observe. So, this part is wet color. So, this and this is dry. So, this should hold left side and the dry part is towards right side left hold. The point of the separation of the two colors is our zero. Fine, children. Now, what comes to the right side? What comes to the left side? Now, we'll understand. The thing which is inside the water, these numbers are negative numbers. Negative means we write minus in front of them. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, so on. To the positive side, to the right side, 1, 2, 3, so on. These are minus, these are plus. We won't write plus, but if nothing is there, that means they are positive integers. So, today we are going to learn about positive integers, negative integers, along with zero are called integers. Our lesson name, integers. Integers. We are stressing the word Z. So, these integers are denoted by the letter Z. So, Z is equal to set, so on, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, so on. This set of numbers are called integers. Integers are denoted by the letter Z. Okay, children? Now, I'll give some more examples to show you. Yes. Suppose, children, imagine this is C. C, what do you know? What is the color of C? Blue color. Now, look how nice it is. Blue color. And in C, what you'll see? Generally, you see boat. Now, where is the boat? It is in the sea, nicely floating. Observe, it is floating on the water and it is above the sea level. And if you take a glass of water, and children, observe, what is this? This is a fish. I'm dropping this fish, toy fish, in the water. What's happening? The fish, see, it is not staying inside. It is to the level of the water. So, this is our zero. This is our zero, and here it is above the sea level. So these values are positive, and we take another glass. See children, this is a lemon. I am dropping this lemon in a glass of water. Now where is the lemon? It is inside the glass. That means it went beneath the water. So if you observe, if I just move, why I am moving this boat or ship towards my right side? Now observe the chain. The fish is on the water, that is zero level. The boat is above the sea level, positive values. And the lemon, which is beneath the water, these are negative values. If you see children, what is this? This is our national flag. This is our national flag. If I put this national flag, look here, this is standing up. So, if you observe, here the part is red, these are negative, and the part above, these are positive. So, if I put it here like this, the red pen, this color shows negative, and the point of the two colors, this is zero. This rod above is above the sea level or above the mountain. This is mountain range, and this is below the mountain. This is surface of the mountain. Okay children, do you follow what I am saying? So I'll draw this vertical line now to show again what are, hope you are understanding what I am conveying children. This is our fish floating. Our boat, these are positive values. From this above, our boat is, or our ship is above the sea level. And towards downwards, these are negative values, -1. -2, -3. Here is the lemon which is inside the water. So this is sea level. We call it as sea level. To the above sea level we have positive values. To the below the sea level we have negative values. In the same way, if you take a mountain, this is the surface of the mountain. And these are the positive values of the mountain, and from here these are negatives. When we go upwards, the value increases. When you move downwards, the value decreases. Okay children, so this is horizontal line of showing number line. Two ways you can show, either horizontal or vertical line, but the concept is same. The concept is negative, positive along with zero. Negative, positive along with zero. Same thing children. Again, let us see some more examples of integers. Let us remind or recall what these numbers are. Okay children, as I told you, this number line, first of all, when you draw the number line of integers, first put chain for zero. This zero divides the number line into negative and positive.
to the positive, to the right side of 0, we have positive values. To the left side of 0, we have negative values. So, let us see some examples. Which is greater, which is smaller by using the symbol less than, greater than. Okay, children? Now, let us concentrate on the numbers. First example. Minus 3. 1. Second one. Minus 10. 10. Minus 3. Or minus 8. You take your own values. Then 5. 12. 33. Minus 35. Okay. Can you see the numbers clearly? I am removing this example. Hope you have followed, children. So, which symbol should be used? Less. If you see, the spelling of less. L-E-S-S. See? L. L. The symbol also in the same way. To the opposite. Greater. Minus 1. Minus 3. 1. Again, I am going to explain now the number line. 0. This is left side. Again, this is right side. What we have towards right side? Positive values. To the left side, we have negative values. When we move from left side to right side, when we move from left to right, the value increases. And vice versa, when we move from left, right to left, the value decreases. So, by observing this, and one more thing, children, the value which is closer to 0, the negative values which are closer to 0 is bigger in value, greatest value. The number, the negative numbers which are far away from, the negative numbers which are far away from 0 are the smallest numbers. We will see some more examples of such type. Minus 3, negative numbers are always less than positive integers. So, we use the symbol less than. Minus 10, minus 8. If we go on writing numbers, who comes first, minus 8 or minus 10? Definitely, minus 8 comes than minus 10. So, automatically, minus 10 is less than minus 8. 5 and 12. 5 and 12, both are positive. So, 5 is less than 12. So, we are simply using less than, no? Now, take another, your wish. 15, 15, 12. 15 is greater or 12 is greater? Automatically 15 is greater. And 33, minus 35. Look, observe, children. This is a positive value. Minus 35 is negative value. So, which symbol I have to use now? I have to use greater. Positive values are always greater than negative values. Okay? Minus 125, 100. Minus 200. Minus 300. 75. Minus 75. 0. Minus 10. 60. Take minus 60, minus 60. Minus 125, 100. First we have to check which number is positive, which number is negative. Minus 125 is a negative. So which is negative numbers are always less than positive. Minus 200, minus 300. If you see, both are negative integers. But while writing on the number line, which number comes closer? Minus 200 comes closer. After that only minus 300 enters. So children, when comparing negative integers, minus 200 is greater because minus 200 is closer to 0 than minus 300. Okay? 75 minus 75. This is positive, negative. So 75 is greater. 0 minus 10. 0 is always greater than negative values. So greater. Minus 60, minus 60. Both are negative. Both are having same value. They are equal. So these are the examples using less than, greater than in the values of integers. So children, will you try 10 more examples, 10 more of your own choice? Of your own choice, 10 examples, 10 numbers, 10 problems using less than, greater than symbol. Okay children, hope you are following. This is the new topic for 6th class children. Today we learn what are integers. Integers are positive numbers, negative numbers along with zero are called integers. Integers, the word, the stress word, stress letter is pronounced as Z. That's why it is, the symbol of integers is Z. So these are the examples. Hope you are following Sheila teacher's class. Thank you.